Video.com. On this video, I want to share to you a comment that was posted recently on one of my videos, and I'm going to read it to you. It says, in caps, "Medical unethical show." I guess it's in caps, so I got to scream. Number one, every video shows medical technical errors. Well, first, let's respond to that. I'm a human. There's going to be errors. There's going to be things that are maybe not perfectly done. But I bet you every provider has things that do a little bit differently. Just because you think it's an error doesn't mean it really is. And even if it is, there's some errors that are not clinically significant and some that are. It probably has to deal more with your interpretation of what an error is and not really where it happened or not. Number two, if he works on an ER, all this video recording slows medical attention and the other patients in the waiting room. That would be true if I was a slow doctor or something like that. I'm actually one of the top two fastest doctors. And on a day like yesterday, I saw 31 patients in 10 hours. That's 3.1 patients an hour. So even with me taking my time to do a little video here, a little video there, and education, I guarantee you my patients are not suffering. We have one of the best ER wait times in the region at our hospital. So I am not compromising anybody else's care because I'm in a room doing an educational video with patients. Plus, you should watch the channel on Larry Melix. He's a teaching physician, teaching facilities. You got to do teaching. That slows people down. You got to sit down, go through things or whatever. You know what? That's the expectation when you go to teaching facilities. Now, I don't work in a teaching facility. So, yeah, that's true. I should be focused on what I'm doing at work. But if it did influence my ability to see more people, certainly I would be the first one to quit because in my ER, we keep a high-end measure on our metrics and performance. Every physician, every provider gets tracked in terms of the response time and how quickly they get to patients, how quickly they put orders in, how quickly they discharge. So believe me, that is not an issue. Number three, all this video recording demands that he has an assistant. Who pays the assistant? Well, no. Most of the times I'm doing the video myself, I have a little tripod and I put the little video camera on the tripod. One time I used the GoPro camera on my head. Sometimes I have a family member hold the phone and get involved in that care. And the last video I did, I had one of my scribes, which is a paid employee by me, to do this and hold the camera down. So not to worry about that. And then he subdivided that comment to A and B. Let's go to that. Someone of the same ER who is paid by the institution and is wasting his or her time doing the recording, or someone paid by this doctor? He said probably not. Yes, it is. And a lot of times I use the same family member to get involved and do the recording for me. Four, if he works in an ER, have you noticed that he must be selecting his patients? Well, duh. I don't record every patient encounter. I record things that are relevant, that are cool, that have important teaching points about it. So no, I don't select. I don't record everybody. I just select my patients. And so I select in order to produce my videos. Then his YouTube show can only be generated by surgical procedures, so he's selecting his patients. This is not ethical and affects the attention of all patients who look for medical care in that ER. Well, if you do follow my channel and you do look at my channel, you'll see that it's not just procedures. I do case discussions, I do EKG, I do x-rays, I do clinical improvement, clinical nuggets, I just start doing the medical minute, I'll do x-ray interpretations, I'll even do things on patient care perceptions and other medical education, and it's my channel. I do with it what I want. So what was the point of this? I forget. Oh, not ethical because I only selecting procedures. Well, procedures, see, when I started this channel, I started doing it to build a database of video so I could create educational videos that patients could watch at home about the care they receive in the emergency department. That's how I generated ED Exit Video. If you go to that website, entirely free for patients. They go in and they type gallbladder disease and the videos come up related to that. Yeah, there's not that many procedures there. That's mostly for patient care. And it's something I did. It cost me a whole lot of my money that I use out of my 401k to build up the website, to build up the app for the iPad called DD Exit Video, which is totally free for patients to download and use. The only thing that I make money on is the iPad app, the Pro version, which has had a whopping 40 downloads, that physicians or medical providers can download, pay money, because then that allows them to do other stuff like sharing the videos, upload their own videos, and use it for patient care at the bedside. So, no, I'm not making a lot of money. And then he says, he's not sharing this information to patients. He's getting YouTube money with patients. It is true. YouTube reimburses on the ads that they get displayed on the video and everything else. So far, I put so much money into ED Exit Video, the apps, the pictures, copyright pictures I need to buy, the equipment I've used to make this, that, believe me, I'm nowhere near making any profit. And even if I did, do you think that doctors who write books like this do it because they, you know, that's fine? No, they get money for it. Do they have pictures on patients and cases? Yes, they do. Do they have case scenarios with pictures and things like that? Yes, they do. And then they get reimbursed for it. So I don't see what the unethical nature of that would be. But I'm glad you shared the video, because you know what? It's been a long time since I had one of you old trolls bash me on YouTube. You guys have behaved well lately. And it happens every 3 or 4 months. Somebody gets on my case and knocks me down and talks about my ethical nature or whether or not I'm doing this correctly or incorrectly. Listen, about the correctness of the procedures or not, I'm providing very good patient care. I monitor my outcomes. I follow with patients. And mostly, I improve watching myself do what I do. People who comment certain things, I'm like, I didn't think of that. You know what? That's a good thought. At least I'm trying to improve myself, improve other people, educate. And if you follow my channel at all, you see, I'm honest, I'm open, and I'm willing to improve. And to think that I cannot improve, yes, they can. I've been practicing 10 years, and there's plenty more to learn. I find myself being a better physician every day. So, hope you like this comment video, and do comment below, share it, and like it. Thank you.